Good morning, Bishop Gorman.
I'm Ryan Meservey.
And I'm Nicole Terramina.
Did you know that on today's date, 1965, Pope Paul VI became the first pope to visit the United States?
I didn't, but that's pretty cool. Also, Pope Francis is the first pope to have a Twitter account.
Yeah, that pope, he seems like a pretty chill dude. He really wants to understand the younger generation and make a difference in the world today.
Let us remember we are in God's holy presence. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Dear Lord, on this, the feast day of St. Francis of Assisi, the namesake of our new pope, help us to live by his example, to be humble, to not let material riches control our lives, but rather follow in his footsteps of love, compassion, and forgiveness. Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.
Now for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Are you ready for the best day ever, Bishop Gorman?
Because BGTV is coming at you in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. This could possibly be the best day ever.
Bertram.
And I'm Michael Delmont.
And this is BGTV. It's Friday, October 4th, 2013, and it's National Taco Day. In 2012, Americans ate 4.5 billion tacos.
Yeah, I could go for a taco right now. Listen up, because we're only saying the announcements once. Ladies, the first powder puff practice is this Saturday. For those who are interested in court cases, there will be tryouts for mock trial held October 8th at 6 p.m. in room 308. This past weekend, 650 students competed for speech and debate at Green Valley High School. Congratulations to Nathan Hill, Jimmy Lau, Noah Lee, and Christian Moorhead on their outstanding achievement.
In October, the world sees pink. Carla McCormick has a story.
Odds of becoming the president, 1 in 10 million. Odds of winning an Olympic medal, 1 in 662,000. Odds of finding a four-leaf clover, 1 in 10,000. Odds that a male is afraid of spiders, 1 in 83. Odds of a woman getting breast cancer in her lifetime, 1 in 8. It's Breast Cancer Awareness Month. Do you know the odds?
These past few months, Bishop Gorman has been working on going green. Here's Jordan Hall with the rooftop scoop.
Many of us have been hearing the loud noises on the roof lately and wondering what's going on. I'm here to reassure you that the sky is not falling. In fact, that is the sound of Gorman going green.
As many of you know, our natural resources are slowly depleting, and it's important for the world to not only acknowledge the problem, but to do something about it. For the past 6 weeks, construction workers have been hard at work installing solar panels on the roofs of just about every building on campus. Luckily, in this Las Vegas heat, solar panels can greatly reduce the amount of electrical energy we use up. In fact, these solar panels can save us about 3 months' worth of power per year. They can even be of use on cloudy days.
Whenever we do have cloudy weather here in Las Vegas, we can use that data in the classroom and see how it affects efficiency, so it directly relates again to the classroom itself.
You can check out how much solar energy we are using on a special computer at the front reception desk or at home by visiting this website.
I'm Jordan Hall, reporting to you from BGTV.
Grab your super suits, but leave your mask and tights at home, because the heroes of the hallway require you to follow a few things in order for you not to receive severe punishments.
Citizens of Bishop Gotham High School, I have come from great lengths to inform you of something very, very important. Calm down, students. Now is not the time for fear. That comes later. Do not wear hooded sweatshirts.
Gentlemen, stop! What are you guys wearing? Stop!
And when are hoodies allowed? Never.
No masks or sweatpants.
What are you doing? No masks.
Well,
what are you thinking? What's this?
I could have sworn I had a bee on my chest.
Well, there's not.
I'm Batman.
You're not Batman.
What's wrong with the mask, though? I'm Batman.
There's no mask. Okay. There's no bee. What's this?
It's just sweatpants. They're comfy. What's wrong with sweatpants?
Why can you wear hoodies?
Never.
Why can you wear sweatpants? Never.
Absolutely no wearing short shorts, leggings, or yoga pants.
Hey guys, are you still taking the pit?
Really?
It will be extremely painful for you if you don't abide by these rules. I believe it is time for me to depart. Farewell, Bishop Gotham.
And remember, no masks.
If you want to go up, up, and out of your way to have the best outfits during homecoming week, get ready for the dress-up theme days.
Monday is Superhero Day.
Tuesday, Captain America, Red, White, and Blue Day.
Thursday, Partners in Crime Day, also Twin Day.
Friday, Orange and Blue Day.
Admin Assemble!
Congratulations to our senior class royalty, Amelia Amiri, Charlotte Brasha, Natalia Corey, Nicole Siz, Ellie Forche, Catherine Forsyth, Caroline Kelly, Savannah Pranger, and Bailey Roberts.
Connor Higgins, Kelvin Hopple, Matt Judd, Cole Krasmarzik, Chris Lawley, Miles Lupe, Bryce McEachern, Pierce Wasserkrug, and Dylan Weldon. Congratulations, everyone. You know who also deserves some recognition? Our sports teams. Take it away, Nick.
Let's kick things off with the soccer team who took on Desert Oasis. The men won their match 2-0, and the women won 3-1. The tennis team faced Centennial with the women winning 16-2 and the men winning 15-3. Our women's volleyball team took on Desert Oasis, winning 3-0. Women's golf won their fourth league match over Desert Oasis this past Wednesday. The cross-country teams had their last home meet of the season Wednesday, and they went down against Legacy. Our football team is taking on their toughest challenge tonight. Our own Kelton Sorensen has the latest.
This week, the team's intensity has heightened as they prepare to host the number one team in the nation, Booker T. Washington out of Miami, Florida. Two of the top nationally ranked teams will be clashing in our own backyard.
Really, when we looked at the schedule at the beginning of the season, we just wanted to load it up with the most, kind of like the highest profile, toughest games we possibly could get. So, you know, Booker T was one of those. We didn't know what they'd be ranked. We knew they'd be ranked high, but it's no different than what we've done every year. We always look to take on, the best, challenges possible.
Our Bishop Gorman Gales are coming off of a bye week and four straight victories. They play the number one team in the nation tonight. Come out here to Fertitta Field and support our Gorman Gales. I'm Kelton Sorensen with BGTV.
I hope to see everybody at the game tonight. I'm Nick Morea. Have a great day.
Thanks, Nick. Well, that wraps us up for this busy Friday morning. I'm Michael Delmont.
I hope everyone has a great weekend. I'm Caitlan Bertram.
And this is BGTV. This could possibly be.